Optimization is a process of making something as good or effective as possible. In our case, finding the balance between quality and performance. Maintaining both them at the same time is quite a challenge, so today I've prepared 5 tips to help you optimize your environments. Let's check it out. There are many things that can cause poor performance, but one of the leading causes is overdraw. Okay, but what is it? Scientifically speaking, overdraw is a process in which during the rendering of the pixel by GPU, it's replaced by the one that is closer to the viewport. Tough definition, I know. But for example, we have an object and there is a fog card in front of it. So the GPU will first render what's behind the fog card and then overlay the fog on top of it, because fog is in some way transparent, so the initial pixels are being replaced by those that are closer to the viewport. And this process of over-rendering can happen several times for a single pixel, which is not good. When it comes to optimization, Unreal Engine has a lot of features and different viewports to help us visualize and find where the problem is, and they'll be very useful to us today. Let's jump into Unreal. So when I go to view mode and optimization view modes, we can see that there are a bunch of different view modes. We've talked about overdraw, so let's start with it and select quad overdraw. This view mode shows us how many times each pixel is rendered by GPU. And in my case, I have a lot of green, so here we can see that every green pixel is getting rendered 4 times. So what can we do about it? The first tip, actually one of the most important ones, which help reducing number of triangles and overdraw, is to use LODs on your meshes. Level of detail, or LOD, is a system that basically creates multiple versions of an original mesh that have less and less triangles and then manage them based on your distance to a given object. In Unreal, it's based on a screen size, but it's very similar. And when you are very close, it will load the highest LOD mesh, which is the most detailed and has the most triangles. And then you move away, it will swap to another LOD and another LOD, which has less triangles. So generally, LOD system reduces the amount of triangles you have and saves some overdraw calculations. Setting up LODs is very simple. If you're using models from Megascans, they include LODs to every mesh and everything is automatic, so you're just chilling. But if you have your own custom models and want to create LODs, double click on the mesh. In details panel, find the LOD settings. Unreal has various presets that are very useful and you will find them in the LOD group. For example, this mesh is small, so I'm gonna set it as small prop. Give Unreal a few seconds. And when we move away, we can see that triangles are being reduced here on the top left. And the LOD system is basically working. If you want to have more control and don't want to use any presets, after painting mesh, the first thing we have to do is to determine the number of LODs in LOD settings. So I'm gonna type 4 and give Unreal a few seconds to generate them. The next thing we have to do is to disable auto-compute LOD distances, switch on custom mode, and now you can change screen size for each LOD separately, and change the percentage of reduced triangles in reduction settings to your liking. Once everything is set up, Unreal has a special view mode to visualize it. So hover over LOD coloration and choose Mesh LOD coloration. Especially when you have multiple models next to each other, that's when you see the power of this system, how quickly and smoothly it changes meshes, reduces triangles and overdraw. This is overdraw comparison of pure objects and after applying LODs. And these are the renders without and with LOD system. Looks identical. We've reduced number of triangles, which helped a bit with overdraw, but that's not the end, because the biggest overdraw burden are particle systems. For example, here I have a very simple fog particle system, and as you can see, it's extremely heavy. Pixels are being generated 10 times, which brings us to the second tip, which is use LODs on particle systems. So this time, based on the distance, we're gonna decrease the number of particles that are being generated. After painting your particle system, I'm gonna create, for example, 3 LODs. It's very easy to move through them using these buttons, or you can type the LOD number here. First of all, let's set the LOD distances. In Details panel, find the LOD tab, and here we can set the distance in units. So I'm gonna set it, for example, 2000, 5000 and 10,000. Okay, The next thing we have to do is to set reduction of particles, which is in spawn module and here in write. So let's go to LOD1, let's duplicate spawn module so we can edit it, and now change the constant to I had 50 on LOD0, so this one gonna be 30, for example. Let's go to another LOD, duplicate spawn module, and I'm gonna set it to 15. And our last LOD, duplicate spawn module, and I'm gonna just enter 0, so it'll just slowly disappear after 10,000 units. Because when we are really far away, there's no need to make these calculations by GPU. Let's now go back to LOD0 and close this window. And by the way, you won't see any changes in viewport, I'm not sure why, so you have to launch the game to see how this LOD system is working. Here is the overdraw comparison for LOD 0, 1, 2, and 3, which disables the particle system. And remember, set your own distance settings, set your own particle reduction settings, adjust everything to suit yourself, and it will definitely save you a few milliseconds in performance. So, we've done triangle and particle optimization, we've dealt with overdraw, now let's focus on something easier, textures. And my next third tip is to make sure that you use right size textures in order to generate mipmaps. Mipmaps are something like LODs, but for textures. So Unreal generates multiple versions of a particular texture, which are progressively lower resolution, and then manage them automatically. Here you don't have to do anything, just make sure that your textures are the power of 2, which is industry standard. And if you want to check it out, double click on the given texture, and you can actually see here that 13 MIPS have been generated. So if you are using any custom textures, I recommend to verify if they are power of 2. If not, you can simply resize them in Photoshop, GIMP, whatever software you use, or pad them in Unreal in texture settings. My fourth tip is to don't use oversized textures. And I mean, ask yourself what texture size for a given model is needed. Is it 8K, 4K, maybe 2K? For film quality, of course, use the highest resolution, who cares? But when it comes to games, I think 8K is pretty much overkill. Of course, you can use it on a certain larger objects, but remember, when you have hundreds of different textures, you can run into some memory issues. If you don't know which texture resolution should you use, Unreal has required texture resolution view mode to help you with it. So I'm gonna choose this view mode and select, for example, this mesh, and choose albedo texture. Now we can see that this texture is in green, which means it's 2 times over resolution. Of course, if we get really close to it, we'll find that the resolution is missing. But really, ask yourself if you ever will be that close to it in a normal situation. If not, consider reducing the texture, and not just albedo, but also normal map and roughness, which will save you a lot of memory, especially when you have hundreds of different textures, and prevent any memory or streaming problems. And finally, as the fifth tip, I'd like to talk about lighting optimization. And we're gonna mainly focus on small lights, because they are the ones that most often cause a drop in performance. Overall, in Unreal, we have 3 types of small lights. Spotlight, point light, and rectangle light. So the first thing we need to ask ourselves is, do we need these lights to be dynamic or static? Dynamic lights are really heavy, and whenever you can, set them to static and later bake the lighting and simply forget about them. This is the best solution. But if you need to use dynamic lights, the best thing we can do is to change the effectiveness radius of every point and rect lights, because default value is often too big. Unreal has special view mode which shows light complexity, and it visualizes the same color pattern as overdraw. So blue is great, and the closer you get to the white, the worse it gets. So I'm gonna select light complexity view mode, and you can see that this light affects crazy amount of space. And in this situation, there is no point to make useless calculations. So to fix it, we can decrease the attenuation radius here in details panel and eyeball the size more or less. And now it looks way better. This is the comparison between leaving default settings on 4 dynamic lights close to each other and here optimizing it. And here are the renders. And optimizing it. The next thing we can do is to set up draw distance, which basically means that light will no longer be visible from a certain distance. It may sound a little strange that we disable lights, but the solution is actually very common among games. You can even notice it in Cyberpunk, especially at night when there are tens of different lights and you drive through the night city, you can observe they slowly appear in the distance. So to set it up, I'm gonna select this light and in details panel find the performance settings. And here you can set after how many units the light will disappear. I'm gonna set it to, for example, 3000, and to make it less visible, second option will help us with fading it out, so I'm gonna set it to 500. And when we move away, it's very fluent. And the last thing you can do is to turn off casting shadows option on certain lights. You know, in some cases it's not the lights, but the shadows that are the source of the problem, especially when there are a lot of triangles in the range of the light. For sure you have some lights that are very close to the ground or simply not that important. So consider turning shadows off and for sure it will improve your performance. And to do it, select your light and then in details panel, turn off cast shadows option. So let's wrap everything. Firstly, always use LODs on your meshes and particle systems to help reduce overdraw and number of triangles. Make sure your textures have the power of 2 in order to generate mipmaps. Don't use oversized textures so you won't run into any memory or streaming problems. And try to optimize all the small lights. And by that I mean bake lighting whenever you can, decrease the attenuation radius, and whenever you can, turn off casting shadows option. Thank you for watching. Remember that optimization is finding the balance between quality and performance, so try not to go to any of these extremes. Consider subscribing for more content just like this. And if you have any more questions, please let me know.